And ladies and gentlemen, without any ado, let's now begin with our inaugural session. I'm going to first request Mr. Rajkumar Sharma, who is ICRA president, to give the welcome note. Let's all welcome him with a round of applause.
A very good morning, and to our chief guest, Shri Vijay Raghavanji, Principal Scientific Advisor to Government of India, Chairman Shri Sahasrabudeji, AICT Chairman, and Shri Reji Kumar Pillai, he is the President for National Smart Grid Forum. Our sponsors, partners, delegates sitting here, in fact, and thousands of delegates are watching us online, and our friends from media as well. Welcome to all of you for this second edition of Global Artificial Intelligence Summit. If I say in fact this, after 2 years of pandemic, we all have started living in a manner with a virus, like almost everybody's been affected because of this in some of the aspects. And I would say, after 2 years, when we are trying to adjust our life living with this, again the time is to move on. This physical event we have decided to organize, it was really a tough challenge for us, because people have developed a habit to be more virtual rather having a physical things now. But we, just because of the support from all of you, encouragement we received, so we decided to have this event now. And time is to move on, rather just waiting and creeping for the things. We already had this event last time when most of the corporates, government institutions and academia have been here. And in last session, in fact, we discussed all AI challenges we are facing in India and opportunities as well. And that time we discussed some agenda and drafted some agenda for us, for ourselves, to help the entire ecosystem of system of AI in India. So we have taken some initiatives and accomplishments we have, which I'd like to share it with you. The first one, we set up Center of Excellence on Industry 4.0 with the help of NPC, National Productivity Council, DPIIT, and we have set up that Center of Excellence in the NPC Bhavan itself. Any of you can go there and have an experience as well. So this is more of the things you can, like whatever the technologies are being used in industry, you can have a look and feel there. And we have also started inviting various HODs from the universities and colleges out there, and vice chancellors as well, so that we can deploy the similar kind of a setup in the universities and colleges across India. We have done it last year, in fact, and now we are rolling it out across India, out of which five sign-off we have already done with the five universities, in fact. So I think within next 3 to 4 months you can have that same kind of experience in different universities as well. So this is one of the initiative AICRA have taken. And the second thing, we already was setting up robotics lab in the schools. We started, you must have heard about Atal Tinkering Lab, but that was not having access to all these schools actually. So at the same time, we have launched this NXR concept, and we have upgraded that concept. We have involved artificial intelligence and other technologies as well with the lab. So as of now, we have set up around 180 plus labs across India in the school itself. So that provides all the facilities, like they can make their own projects on different technologies. All faculty support is there, means we have deployed faculty there, and they can highlight and they can showcase their whatever they develop, in fact. So like we are the organizer of world's largest robotic championship event. I believe most of you have heard about it, Technosian. In fact, in 2019, sir, we have organized this event at Tyagaraj Stadium itself, wherein 22 countries have participated there, and around 28,000 students were there from different countries in India itself, wherein they have showcased their accomplishments and the projects, whatever they have developed. So that lab give them opportunity so that they can be exposed in front of venture capitalists or corporates and government institutions as well. So this is another thing we have done. Apart from this, we know that there are many institutions across India, like I'm talking about vocational institutions, computer institutions, who have the infrastructure in place and they have faculties as well. But the challenge is they are still teaching the similar traditional kind of a technology programs. So we have launched one program called Robotic Skill Center. So we started upgrading those vocational institutions into Robotic Skill Center. And we have around 20 plus programs that covers almost all the Industry 4.0 technology, including artificial intelligence. So now these skill centers, because they have a faculty, so we provide them absolutely free train-the-trainer programs. So their faculties can be, you know, upgrade themselves. And this kind of technology can be accessible across India, not only limited to major cities, in fact. So we have done it in around 250 plus centers across India as of now. Apart from this, we have also launched a tech startup program. See, today we face a challenge for any startups. They require different kind of a support. First support can be a technology guidance, right? Another support can be like, obviously everybody talks about startup funding as well, right? And the third requirement is the promotion, like they need to connect with their own target segment, right? So they need a platform wherein they can showcase all these things. So in this program, we have registered lot many startups and we are helping them for all the, because we have a 3000 plus membership base who are the experts and working different technology organizations. So they help them to understand and give them a guidance. And we also help them to raise the funds for their own startups. And we have different platforms wherein they can showcase their whatever they're doing, right? Like this is the platform. We already have an exhibition hall in the same premise. And further, we have other platforms wherein we can showcase. In fact, we have a publishing house, Future Tech Magazine, which you can access here. So they can showcase and they can write, they can provide all kind of write-ups there, and that magazine can be circulated. We have around 40,000 plus circulation for the same magazine. So all these startups would be getting this mileage. And not only limited to this, we have an concurrence in event, and now we are rolling out tech startup conclave in 10 states capital, in fact. So the first one will start from November onwards from Bangalore. And then after major cities across India, wherein all these startups would be coming to one place and wherein they can connect with the guides and the experts, and they can exchange knowledge, share everything with them, and they can showcase their product and services as well. So this is the kind of activities we are going to roll out from November onwards. So this is what we have done as of now, sir, in AICRA, last 2 years accomplishments and the way forward. And this event is very, very important because as per the Niti Aayog, they have drafted national AI policy. So the major focus is to be there on five industries, which is AI in education, AI in agriculture, AI in healthcare, AI in smart cities, and AI in smart mobility and transportation. And of course, AI startups, right? So there will be a lots of discussion. The best part of this event is like the first ever we got best of the speakers. You will find out in 2 days session, there are researchers, very popular faces in India and outside India, and they are the head of the organizations and head of the government institution also. So next 2 days, all of you can exchange knowledge, experience with them, right, and have fun. And one last thing before I end my speech. India have best of the IT professionals, right? And fortunately, this government is infusing huge fund for technology development in India, right? So this can be the best time for us, and entire world is watching us, what India is doing. And India can become a destination for artificial intelligence as a market and as a service provider as well. So all, if all of us join hand together and work in this direction, certainly India will become a leading country in artificial intelligence. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.